gentlemen, I give you a name that will remain forever vital with courage and vibrant with inspiration. Thomas Alva Edison.
Toastmaster, ladies and gentlemen, to be told by the outstanding men and women of your time that you have contributed a great deal to human betterment is pleasant, very pleasant. I'd hardly be human, my heart didn't fill from such a magnificent compliment. But somehow I have not yet achieved a success I want. Earlier this evening, I talked with two school children. Tomorrow, the world will be theirs. It's a troubled world, full of doubt and uncertainty. You say we men of science have been helping it. Are those children and their children going to approve of what we've done? Or are they going to discover too late that science was trusted too much, so that it has turned into a monster whose final triumph is man's own destruction? Some of us are beginning to feel that danger, but it can be avoided. I once had two dynamos. They needed regulating. It was a problem of balance and adjustment. And I feel that the confusion in the world today presents much the same problem. The dynamo of man's God-given ingenuity is running away with the dynamo of his equally God-given humanity. I am too old now to do much more than to say, put those dynamos in balance. Make them work in harmony, as the great designer intended they should. It can be done. What man's mind can see, man's character can control. Man must learn that, and then we needn't be afraid of tomorrow. And man will go forward toward more light.